morning, students. Welcome to the new session in this e-learning program. Today we are going to discuss about the rules, how to draw the radiograms. The branch of physics which deals with the light is known as optics. Optics is mainly divided into two parts. One is ray optics, second one is wave optics. Ray optics is little bit easier to understand. That's why up to 10th class we are having only ray optics. Wave optics is little complicated one. So in our higher studies we learn about wave optics. So ray optics in the sense the light ray behaves as a ray of light like this. In wave optics the nature of the light is explained as a wave. That's complicated. So we'll start with the rules. In this ray optics. The ray diagrams are very, very, very important. To draw these ray diagrams, we should be little familiar with the rules. If you know the rules, then it is very easy for us to draw any kind of ray diagram which is given in the exam or any other competitive exams. So this lesson is very important. In this maximum 4 marks or minimum, we'll get 2 marks. The weightage of this lesson. So we should be very careful while drawing the ray diagrams. Very simple mistakes the student will do while drawing these ray diagrams. The first one is we will forget to coat the lower part of the concave mirror, or we will forget to draw the arrow marks. Because this is ray optics, this arrow mark is very compulsory. It is essential. If you are not mentioning, we can't identify in which direction the light ray is passing. So here I will mention this direction means. This direction represents, this is incident ray. This light ray is incidenting from the source towards the mirror. These are the mistakes generally the student will do. So if we learn thoroughly, we never do such kind of mistakes in the exams. So it's simple mistakes, we may lose marks. So we don't do that. So for that, if you are not supposed to do like this, we have to learn these 3 rules. So I know you will do. So take your book and pen, scale along with your pencil. So these ray diagrams you have to draw along with your scale. Don't forget to use your scales by drawing ray diagrams. The first rule we are going to learn. The rays from the source. No, I am not going to mention every time. Always the light rays will come from a light source. The rays which are coming parallel to the principal axis. So obviously the ray will come and hit the surface of the concave mirror, the mirror surface. Just don't forget, a light source can emit a beam of a bunch of rays, millions of rays. But here we are considering only one ray for our flexibility in drawing the diagrams. The ray which is parallel to the principal axis, after hitting the surface of the concave mirror, obviously its opaque surface, the light does not penetrate to the surface, it bounces back, it comes back. So the nature of the ray which is parallel to principal axis after reflection, it will pass through the focus. Don't forget, it passes through the focal point. It passes through the focus. So this is incidenting ray and this is reflective ray. So no need to mention R here. The arrow mark itself indicates shows this is a reflective ray. Incident ray and this is reflective. This is the first rule. The ray which is parallel to principal axis after reflection, it passes through the focal point. Pause the video here and draw the ray diagram. Practice this ray diagram without any mistakes. For this is first rule. If it is okay, then we'll go to the rule number 2. Just first observe and then draw diagrams. This is second rule. The rays which is passing through the focus. Don't get confused. Here the rays are parallel. After reflection, they are coming to the focus. Here, when it comes to the second case, the rays which are passing through the focus, after reflection, they will become parallel to the principal axis. Just observe these arrow marks carefully. So with these arrow marks, only the diagram will be perfect. It says everything. The rays passing through. Where from we are getting the rays? Yes, from the light source. So we are not. I am not mentioning the light source here. The rays which are passing through the focus after reflection will become parallel to the principal axis. Is it clear? I hope so. This pass
your
and draw the ray diagram in your book. Then we'll go to the third rule, the final rule. The rays which are passing through the center of curvature, the light ray which is passing, rays which are passing through the center of curvature, after reflection they will follow the same path. After reflection they will follow the same path. These are the three simple rules. If we combine these rules, three rules, we'll get a complicated image. That's why individually we are learning. I forgot. Pass here and follow and draw the ray diagram. It may be simple, but we have to practice these ray diagrams. And one more point. So here, this is center of curvature. Even this is also passing through the center of curvature. This is also you can construct. The ray which is passing through on the principal axis, over the principal axis, it follows the same path after reflection. This is rule number one, rule number two, and this is rule number three. These are for concave mirrors. Don't forget, these are for concave mirrors, and convex mirrors we'll learn in the another session. If we combine these three rules together, we'll get this is a complex image. So this complex image, that's why we are rule one after one we are learning, and we are combining with the help of these three rules. Now we are going to draw a ray diagram. This is our candle. Here I took the object source, the point source, the candle. So here from candle we are considering, we know so many light rays will emit, the candle can emit so many light rays, but we are considering three rays because we learned these three rules. The first rule, which is parallel to principal axis, after reflection it passes through focus. The first rule. It's the first rule. We draw this one. Now we are drawing this one. The ray which is passing through the focus, after reflection it will come parallel to the principal axis. And we draw the second rule also. Now we have final rule we are going to draw. The ray which is passing through center of curvature, it bounces back. The ray which is passing through the center of curvature, it bounces back. So this is very important. Where all the three rays will overlap, intersect, there we'll get the image of the source. This intersection point is very important. In further classes we'll have an activity. In that activity we'll keep the nature of object, the position of object, and the nature of image, all we'll learn. So I want to conclude this session. So before that, just make sure that you have to learn these three rules and practice these rules and practice this diagram also. So till then, stay home, stay safe.